Wayne, the idea of financial planning, you get started, you start turning over rocks, it turns into this enormous mountain of tasks, to-do lists. I've got $100 in my pocket, and I've got $200 worth of needs, $200 worth of goals, so I want to do nothing. How do I get past that? How do I get started?
We need to realize that It's a lifelong project. It's not a day's event. We aren't going to do something and have it happen today. And yes, financial planning is big. You know, procrastination is our number one enemy. And it's because if we're talking about estate planning, we get into conversations about what we're going to leave the kids or what charity or who's going to be the decision maker or who's going to be our guardian.
That one shuts down conversations.
And most young people don't have a will because they can't figure out who could raise their kids.
And nobody can. And so in that specific case, for Melinda and I, that was the most difficult conversation we had in our financial plan. 100% absolutely true. And that's just one aspect of it.
And so when we get to those difficult conversations, it's easier to go watch TV, mow the lawn, do it. Because they oftentimes get emotional. They get between spouses, whatever. And so it's easier to put it off. We'll do it tomorrow. Tomorrow never comes because there's always something more fun to do than planning.
Sure. You know, the idea of priorities, it's important. Financial planning is important. It's never urgent unless we make it so. So we know we should do it. We know we should be going towards that. But to get you to take action, I think I've heard you say this in the past, when we get to a decision point, yes, no, or worst case, set a date. A date to make that decision. Don't just let it simmer on the back.
And oftentimes, people talking to me, I think, say, well, you know, he's just trying to sell me, or he's just trying. But literally, for me to be my best for them, for me to help you be your best, I should always get you to a mode of yes, no, or saying, and no is a fine answer.
Sure.
There's nothing wrong with no. But we need to make a decision because tomorrow never comes. People don't need an estate plan until 30 seconds before they die.
Sure.
We don't need an estate plan. So most people run around with either no documents or documents that talk about somebody they don't love anymore.
Right.
Or documents that they never let anybody really dream with them and think outside the box. And it's tough. So we put it off. We need to be prepared. What's statistically interesting is people that plan live longer than people that don't. Right. So just based on that statistic, I would say we should all plan, we should quit procrastinating, and we should win. Okay. Now there's a reason that statistic is that way, because people that plan take better care of themselves, but we should plan.
Sure.
We should take action. We need, and part of that is remembering who it's about. What it's for, why we're doing.
Not about the stuff, people. People should always drive our decisions, my opinion, over the stuff. The people that we love, whether that's charities, whether that's family, but the people are more important than the stuff for sure.
And procrastination is such an evil thing because, you know, if we're whatever age and we gotta get to this financial goal, if we start today, that's a little bit of a steep hill, but if we put it off over here, it becomes impossible. And we have to lower our goal to make it work.
Right.
And so procrastination's your enemy. Find a reason to take action, not a reason not to. Financial planning is always, I think, like the elephant. It's impossible to really see how we can eat it, but you've got to take the first bite. So whatever you're trying to do, whatever you're trying to be, today's a great day to take that first bite of your future.